Right, so to your first question, it's pretty unsurprising that the Russians are trying again. This is something that former special counsel Robert Mueller warned about when he testified last year, saying that, look, the Russians are actually doing this right now. They're interfering and they're trying to sow chaos and division just like they did in 2016. So that part is not necessarily surprising. What is a bit surprising is that, like you said, Bernie Sanders' campaign seems to have been sitting on this for roughly a month. Their excuse now is that this was a classified briefing, and as a sitting U.S. senator, he does have access to this kind of classified information. But it's unclear whether the IC that briefed him, the IC officials that briefed him, would have given him classified information. That's something that we just don't know. And Bernie Sanders, of course, could have taken the liberty to ask them, look, just so it seems like I'm not sitting on this, like I'm not trying to be, not transparent, can I reveal basically what you said, which is that the Russians are interfering, they're operating a social media campaign or whatever in order to boost my candidacy, we reject it. That is something that, according to FBI officials that I spoke to, who have done these kinds of briefings in the past, say that it's completely his right to ask them, and the IC likely would have not pushed back strongly against that request, just because hiding this and hiding, you know, Russian attempts to help your campaign actually would create leverage for the Russians and for malicious actors who might want to try to blackmail the Sanders campaign or whatever it may be. We ran into the same issue in 2016 with the Trump campaign, where issues of blackmail and leverage arose in the Russians' interference in that instance as well. So it definitely raises questions about why the Sanders campaign was not more forthcoming about this, knowing that it probably would have come out eventually, especially because the IC officials briefed Congress on this. But moving forward, we're going to have to see how they respond to this, because it's not going to go away. The Russians are trying to prop up Bernie Sanders, and they're trying to prop up the president, because they know that by pitting two rivals against each other, they can create maximum division.